Yo, what is good? Welcome to Dunk Tips Tuesday. Today we are talking about how to go from touching the rim to dunking. What's good, guys? If you're new here, we do a dunk tip, or I do a dunk tip every single Tuesday. This is the first episode, so I want to make it super consistent. Any questions you have on your dunk journey, this is the place. I'm going to answer it every single Tuesday. So this channel is all about my dunk journey, my life transformation, and this part of my channel is going to be all about answering those common questions I get. So hit me in the comments, hit me on my Instagram, anywhere you go. So let's just get right into it. It's going to be kind of podcast style. And let's get into it. So I get this question so many times. How do I go from touching the rim to dunking? How long does it take? So to address that question right off the bat, how long does it take? It's very, very variable for everybody. If you're just starting your journey and you're already touching rim and you haven't practiced at all, you can get to dunking really quickly. It could be a couple months, 2 to 3 months, because if you're naturally touching the rim without any training, any practice on your technique work, you can really increase your vertical fast. The thing is, some people are very different. Some people have naturally used their potential in their body very well, and their training needs a lot of high level work, whether it's gaining a lot of strength, gaining a lot of speed, and that takes time. So for how long it takes to get from touching to rim to dunking, it's very variable, but I don't think it'll take more than 2 years. That's just a total guess, but think about that. If you're 15 years old, 20 years old, 2 years flies by. I've been on my dunk journey for almost 10 years now, and it feels like I'm learning every single day. So I'm also making this because I want you to learn from my mistakes and also learn what I've done well, so that way you can keep making progress every step of the way. So that's why I say 2 years. That's why I say don't worry about how long it takes, because I want you to make the best choice now for your training. So that way in 2 years from now, you're still going up and you're maxing out your potential. Because if you get your first dunk in a couple months and you're barely touching it and you're doing it on a low rim and you're just doing it with one technique, carve one pattern, and you only can dunk with off a lob if someone throws it to you, that's not as great as if you barely can dunk, but you're doing it off the dribble. You're doing it off all plants in 2 years. You get what I'm saying? So that 2 years, it could be so different depending on how you structure your training. So how do you do it? How do you get from touching the rim to dunking? I said this in my very first vlog, and it's still true to this day, but there's more to it. And I say just jump. So a lot of you, I'm 28. I just had a birthday two weeks ago. But for a lot of people that are a lot younger, or even if you're just starting your training, you can get so much out of just jumping. And here's why. When you think of jumping, it seems like a gift. It seems like something that people have or don't have. And that's how I thought of it before I started my dunk journey. That's why it's transformed my life so much. And I'm here to tell you that you can train it. Just like running faster or running further, jumping is the same way. When you practice it, you get better at it. No matter what you do in your training, you have to jump a lot. So everybody I meet, when I ask them, how do I jump higher? I ask them, are they jumping often? Are they jumping consistent? So start jumping consistently where it's a workout. The same way every guy I know hits the gym, especially in high school, everybody starts hitting the gym. You go consistently. And because of that, in such easier movements, there's a lot less to a bicep curl. You start to notice it. You get a pump right away. You don't really get a pump from jumping. If you did, you'd probably stick to it. But that's the thing, is you jump, you might feel warm. You've probably felt that before, is where you feel warm and you start jumping a little better. But take note of that. And when you start jumping consistently, you'll start to learn so much about your body, so much about your technique. And that is such a great tool for you to build that foundation of jumping. So jump a lot, but also be aware of what you're feeling. So start jumping, and I'm going to give you a little more details about what that means. So don't just start jumping. Try to count how many jumps you do. Do a full warm-up. Wait till you feel that adrenaline, your blood flowing, you're sweating. Then start jumping. Start jumping right-left and left-right, both plants. 1 foot, 2 foot, but also both feet. So 1 foot off your left, 1 foot off your right, and take note, actual notes, take detailed notes about how many jumps you did, how you felt, measure it, measure every jump. What was the highest of the day? What was the lowest of the day? What was your standstill? What was your running vert? What was your one step vert? All of that right there is probably something you don't do on a normal jump day. You probably don't even have a jump day. So if you make a structured jump day and do that for a few weeks, you will learn so much about your jumping and your vertical just based on that data alone. It's just like going to the gym and counting how many reps you do, counting what workouts you do, and just like working out like your arms. And I'm using this analogy because it's very easy and most of us have this experience. When you work out your arms, you don't want to do the same thing for years, right? So you have to switch it up. That's how it goes. So same thing is true with jumping. You're going to learn about what's worse than others. What plant do you feel more comfortable? Why? And then you ask why and you start to break it down and you bring your questions back to this, because then I could give you more tips on that. But start doing that. So the number one key is start jumping. So you start jumping, you measure those things. So let's go through those really quick one more time. So do your standstill vert. You get warm first, get fully warm, learn about how to get yourself fully warm. Sometimes it's hard without playing a game. A lot of people have trouble with that. I have dynamic warm-ups on my YouTube channel. Just search my warm-up, you'll find it. Do a warm-up, do standstill jumps, do drop step or one step jumps, do maybe some two step, three step jumps, and then full approach. And then do all that with different angles. So do the left, right, and right left, do the 1 foot off left foot and right foot. And there's your jump day. And then count how many jumps you do. Do that twice a week, because that's enough time for your body to recover, but learn about your body. Like today, I have a lot of energy. I'm freaking ready to go. I might go dunk today, even though I jumped a little yesterday. But you start to feel when your body feels the best. And that is huge, because just like jumping, I mean, jumping is super explosive, super needs a ton of energy. That's why I'm big on energy. You can't really do it on a tired day. You won't have that tank. Some days you wake up with it, sometimes you don't. And it's not a when or how do you wake up with that energy. It's a formula. It's what you eat. It's how you slept. It's how your past workouts went, right? So if you're trying to maximize your jump days, start to learn that as well. This is all the foundation building for your best jumping days. So say you do it twice a week, you give yourself enough of rest, you're stretching in between. You see how much goes into just jumping? You stretch in between, you recover in between, you're doing ice baths, you're doing all this dynamic active stretching to get that blood flow, that range of motion, all this stuff, right? Jumping twice a week, then maybe up it to three times a week. Start pushing it. Every single jump session, try to reach higher. And you might go like this. Heads up, for fair warning, is your jumping is never just going to go up, 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 up. We all have good days and then we have some bad days. Don't get discouraged. You didn't do anything wrong. Get more data. If you're going like this, right, and you're not really getting up higher, you're just going up and down, start to notice what's different on those jump days and what you can do. But the point is you need that data is if that low day was you decreasing, most likely you're not decreasing. Nobody just gets lower and lower and lower. The only time you get lower and lower and lower is if you're not jumping at all. You just stop jumping, stop jumping, stop jumping. You have a low day because your muscles are tired, your body's tired, you're fatigued, you're weak, whatever it is, right? Your technique was off that day, but you're most likely not going to lose your bounce. You just don't lose it because your muscles, you're walking every day, you're doing things, and you're jumping a couple times a week. So, but we want to increase, right? But you need that data on those low days to understand why you had that low day. So on your high days, you can make that progress, right? So touching rim to dunking, reach for something above the rim. And I want to keep these around 10 minutes. So I'm going to try to cut this maybe a little, this might be a little longer than usual, but I want to keep these videos right around 10 minutes just to keep you going. So to sum it up, you have the big jump days, you gather the data, but then push yourself. This is really key. Go for the rim and everybody can grab the rim, touch the rim. That's your target. We all know what we want. We don't even have to think about pushing ourselves to get the rim because you're trying to get the rim. And then people get stuck because they go for the rim. Now, try to hit your wrist on the rim. Wrist will be a huge goal for you because if you can hit wrist, you can almost 100% dunk with good technique and good timing, right? But to get from touching the rim to wrist, go for something a little higher. Either raise your rim if you have some rim that you can put something under it and you can make it a little higher. Or go for something on the backboard. Get a ladder, put a piece of tape, and go for that, right? You really got to stimulate yourself. The other thing I like to explain is do these plyometrics. In addition to your jump days, do these plyometrics that are not normal jumps. For example, when you go for a normal jump, you're just running on flat ground and you're taking off. Maybe try doing depth jumps where you're off the ground, where you're starting at a higher point, so you're adding more force to the ground. Do side-to-side lateral movements, because if you work on all these supplemental muscles, they're going to help the main muscle. So do a ton of plyometrics, maximize your speed. I really think maximizing your speed is all you need to go from touching rim to dunking. Unless you've been training for a long, long time and you're 5'5 or under, which I still believe you can dunk 100%. But at that level, at the extreme level, I'm going to end with the extreme level. If you're 5'5", it took you years of training to touch the rim. Now you're going to have to have a couple more years of training hard, of getting super strong so you can produce more force. But most of us that are touching rim haven't gone through years of strength training yet. So maybe it's time you start that. But that's where you got to diagnose. If you haven't maxed out your speed yet, max out your speed with jumping as hard as you can multiple times a week, pushing your training volume, trying to up to 3 to 4 times a week. You don't really need to do more than that. And then pushing yourself to try to get a fraction of an inch. Your goal should be a fraction of an inch higher every week. And if you don't make a progress every single week, every couple weeks, even every month would be fantastic. Imagine if you get a fraction of an inch every month. That would be huge. Say it's a quarter of an inch every month. Do the math. That's 3 inches a year. If I gain 3 inches every year, in 2 years, I'd have close to a 50-inch vertical. That's insane, right? Think about that. That is insane. So max out your speed, use the plyometrics, and if you're not making progress over a longer period of time, 4 to 6 months, it may be time to hit the strength so you can get more force in your muscles and explode higher. All right, guys, that was Dunk Tips Tuesday, episode 1. Leave your comments. Thank you guys for your questions. I hope this becomes a place where I answer your questions every single week so you can really make the most of your dunk training journey and follow my journey as well as I try to hit my goal of 43, 40 inch vert, max vert, and also dunk in games. I'm really excited for this channel. I'm really excited to help you guys. I've helped so many people jump higher, and I really want a place that you guys can get your questions answered because I just know how important that is. So I'll see you every single Tuesday. Dunk Tip Tuesday. Let's go. Boom.